റെസ്പെക്റ്റഡ് സീനിയർ കോമ്രേഡ് കോമ്രേഡ് ലാഷ്കർ സി, സ്റ്റേറ്റ് സെക്രട്ടറി ഓഫ് ദ പാർട്ടി കോമ്രേഡ് ലാപ്സി, കോമ്രേഡ് ശങ്കർ പി ബി മെമ്പർ ഹു ഈസ് ഗോയിങ് ടു പ്രസന്റ് ദ പാർട്ടി പൊസിഷൻ ഓൺ ദ സബ്ജെക്ട് ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് അവർ അപ്രോച്ച് ടു കാസ്റ്റ് ആൻഡ് ഡോക്ടർ അംബേദ്കർ ആൻഡ് കോമ്രേഡ് ഇലവൻ കോമ്രേഡ് അഞ്ചു and all comrades who are present here and all friends. I will not be elaborating much. As a comrade Tuhin just already mentioned that only very rarely communist parties ranging from the right sections to the leftist, that means the so-called, we call revisionist to the adversaries or the sections, never take up such a question. What should be our approach to caste and Dr. Ambedkar? So CPIM and Red Star, when decided to have a plenum on our party's evaluation of the past period, a decision was taken that it should be preceded by a seminar on the communist approach to caste and Dr. Ambedkar. So that is the context of this seminar, and I will be just mentioning a few points. Connected with our understanding of the situation today, that we know that the international communist movement, not only all communist in all the countries of the world, are facing very serious setbacks that we must know, and many of these issues are connected with the what is called the ideological political factors, because the world capital, international capital, is advancing. They are finding out newer and newer avenues of their advancement, but the communist movement is failing to overcome, and it is not only connected with an organizational matter, it is connected with the ideological and political understanding of the situation also. And our party, that is CPIM and Red Star's understanding, is that in general, while there are many problems which are being faced by the international communist movement, in India, the communist movement, one of the serious questions faced by the communist movement in India is regarding the question of caste. Because according to Marxism, which is the methodology, the understanding that Marx has put forward, we know, even when Marx was analyzing the capitalist system in England or in Europe in general, Marx was aware of the situation that in other parts of the world there are other social systems, for example, which Marx called mode of production, which we may call social formation. In other words, we can call it social formation. So Marx understood that even though he analyzed the capitalist mode of production, Marx was very well aware that in other parts of the world, this mode of production which he is analyzing in Europe with respect to England, with respect to the industrial context of the Industrial Revolution, that is not applicable to other countries. That is why Marx put forward that along with the capitalist mode of production, because he had a serious discussions on indigenous people in America, in Africa, and in various parts of the world, Marx has references. So as part of this, he pointed out that there is what is called Asiatic mode of production. And this Asiatic mode of production, Marx formulated mainly with reference to the caste question. We don't go into the details because there are many, because in most of the works of Marx, if you go through that, you will see in Capital, in Contribution to the Critique of Political Economy, in almost all works of Marx. And in most of his articles, he had returned to the New York Daily Tribune during that period. He has references to serious observations on the caste question. But unfortunately, I don't know whether that word is correct or not, this matter was not seriously addressed by the Indian government. Of course, there was efforts. There were certain steps which were there already, because as our party program, CPM and Rashta party program has clearly stated that in 1930, there was a draft platform for action published by the Communist Party at that time. Then it was clearly mentioned that without abolition of caste, there will not be any democracy. There will not be any liberation. There will not be any independence for the country. That was the position. So that much importance was given to the question of caste by the Communist Party during that period in 1930. That is very serious. It is there in the draft platform for action. Comrades, so as a result, I need not go into details. Because of this position, there was a close interaction, close work between Dr. Ambedkar and the communists during the 30s. And in the 1936, Dr. Ambedkar's his unpublished that speech, and undelivered speech, which he proposed to make, but it could not be delivered. That speech he was published later as Annihilation of Caste, which is already there, you know. So based on that, the communists and Dr. Ambedkar were having close relation and they united in work during the 30s. But what happened is that we know it didn't continue. It collapsed since the 40s onward, and these things are part of history. Was an isolated issue. There was certain ideological underpinnings. For example, during that period, especially during the beginning of the 30s, even the very concept of Asiatic mode of production was abandoned. Because during the Leningrad discussions in the 30s in Soviet Union, because Soviet Union was also turning to a position which we have to seriously evaluate. So at that time, the concept of Asiatic mode of production was totally removed from Marxist discussions, and followed by these Indian scholars, they also abandoned the discussion on Asiatic mode of production. And you know that Indian scholars who were associated with CPM, like parties, you know, I just mentioned their name also. For example, Dr. Irfan Khabib, you know. He himself, he's a very renowned scholar, respected scholar, we know. But he said that the advancement of modernity, when modernity advances, caste will wither away. That is, when capitalist advancement is there, caste will wither away. That means according to the traditional understanding, that mechanical understanding of the communist movement, that caste is a superstructural thing. So when when capitalist development abolished caste itself, so these type of things were prevailed, and even as I mentioned, Irfan Khabib himself was one of the exponent of this position, and therefore following Soviet Union, Indian scholars also abandoned the whole discussion. The so-called Marxist scholars also abandoned. I am not saying that there are very serious scholars who took up this matter. They are still continuing. But the official position, the official communist position, never took up this matter in continuation of this position. Satyo, we know that all these are absurd things, because today, you know, the embodiment of Indian science and technology, IITs or centers of higher education, caste is safely seated on the throne of modern education. Similarly, caste is exported by those elite sections who are going from India to abroad. Their caste is going on, caste untouchability is there, cases are going on, in Pennsylvania, in Texas, in Boston. All these we know from reports. So caste is even exported from India. That is also there. So therefore, caste is a social institution, the most inhuman social institution, which will be, which is capable to cut across. So I have to make self-criticism. Only recently we have taken a position that this was not correct. Or that I did not go into details because Comrade Shankar is there, Comrade Lashkarsni is there, the comrades will speak. But one or two points I will say and I will finish my presentation. Comrades, you know that from a very, because we are leftists, because this is all the seminar is being held by CPM and Rashta. So we must know that according to the basics of Marxist analysis, say everything is starting from a class analysis. Because based on the analysis of class in a society, the contradictions, which are or what are the contradictions, identifying the principal contradiction and approaching the situation in such a way that to remove that contradiction, then the social system will move to a higher stage. That is understanding, general understanding. So what? But in doing so, when we make a class analysis of a country, a society, naturally, how? That is, from a Marxist perspective, we must know how, what is called this market, surplus value is extracted. How division of labor is constituted. All these things are very important for Marxist. But in India, if you are going through that, then without caste, you cannot do anything. Because here, division of labor, here work, here job, here wage, everything, wealth, political power, everything is based on, even culture, everything is based on caste. Without caste, there is no social phenomenon, no social sector which is prevailing in India. So still, the so-called communists failed to understand the integral, the inseparable relationship between caste and class. Because we are taking this seminar, our approach to caste and Dr. Ambedkar, we must see that today, I mean, after the 30s, what happened? 1943, there was a party congress, first party congress of the Communist Party, 1943. Second party congress in 1948. Not even a mention of caste was there. No mention. It was not even mentioned in the program. I mean, the program was not there, but even in the documents, there was no mention of caste. So it was made an insignificant matter. And that was prompted. Dr. Ambedkar himself was prompted to say these communists were Brahmin boys. And even Dr. Ambedkar also said that the dictatorship of the proletariat in India will be a dictatorship of the Brahmins. He himself stated, he said, in India the dictatorship of the proletariat will be a dictatorship of the Brahmins. That was Ambedkar's position. And then what happened? The communists turned against Ambedkar and he was questioned and he was stamped as anti-communist. He was against the communist movement. It was not the case. It was the approach of the communists. Self-critically, because communists are claiming that they are having a grand theory. They are claiming that we have a grand theory which is capable of explaining everything. But they failed miserably in the question of these castes. And therefore, Ambedkar was forced to criticize. And naturally, the Ambedkar both Ambedkar and communists who were working together in the 30s became enemies in the 40s, from the 40s onward, and I need not go into the details. So this is the, and now what happens? This tradition continued, and so we must as communists have to make a self-criticism first. Why we failed or how we failed to evaluate this question in the proper perspective. Why the oppressed masses, why the oppressed people of this country are not with the communists? Why they moved away from the communists? Why the working class of India? The working class of India are belonging to the oppressed caste. The working class of India are belonging to the most oppressed class, caste in India. How the communists are failing to organize them? All these questions have to be seriously taken up. Only then the communist movement can move forward in India. Or against caste oppression, when caste discrimination is there, caste oppression is there, post caste atrocities are there, honor killings are there, all parties are coming. Everybody is coming. But they will not say anything about the annihilation of caste. They will be against caste oppression. Caste based discrimination. But the source of this discrimination and oppression is caste. So regarding the annihilation, regarding the abolition, eradication of this most inhuman institution on that question, including the left, very rare opinion is coming. That is the main problem. Now, comrade, today we are in a situation we know that the biggest and the longest running fascist organization, that is RSS. We are in the grip of RSS. And now the BJP, which is, we know, it's a political tool of RSS. Only a political tool of RSS, because RSS is controlling everything. Everything, micro, macro, spheres of the country, state power, everything under the military, civil, administration, everything, education, culture, everything under the control of RSS, we know. That RSS is now basing, using the Manuvadi caste system as its ideological basis. And only if we understand how RSS, how the Indian fascists today are using the its ideological basis as the caste system, Manusmriti, because RSS planned to make the Manusmriti as Indian constitution in 1949 and 50. This historical record. Their organizer, there is a record, they planned to have Manusmriti as the Indian constitution, which is the Bible, which is the ideological basis of the Indian caste system, according to which the untouchables, the oppressed are subhuman, not human beings. Women are subhuman. So such a reactionary, obscurantist concept was, or a book was proposed by RSS as the constitution in 1949-50. And they are in power now through its political tool, BJP. And they are now trying to again bring forward, that is what, in different forms, that it cannot be in the old form. It will be in the, no history, nothing can repeat in the same manner. History is constantly changing. Everything is constantly changing. Therefore, today, they will be changing. But the essence is the same. So, we, the people of India, and all progressive democratic forces of India should understand the seriousness of this question. And only by attacking, only by resisting and defeating uncompromising struggle against the caste system and its ideological and everything connected with that, only by demolishing that, we can overcome fascism also. Otherwise, Indian fascism will continue. Indian fascism, you cannot eliminate Indian fascism on a particular day. It has, even if you fail it, if you defeat it, it will again come up. It will come back with intensified vigor. So that is the situation. Therefore, this caste is, the caste question is very fundamental to our analysis, our understanding, our political action, our organizational build-up. And it is not a tactical or a superstructural one. It is a strategic and it is integral part of the society, polity, economy, political, everything in our country. So with that perspective, CPML Restart party program itself has formulated this caste annihilation and approach to caste in that way. So it is with that perspective that we are organizing this seminar also as part of the plenum. Ajke darbars with these few words, consider this as my just introductory note for the serious discussion on our subject, which is going to take place. So our revolutionary greetings to all.
उसी के साथियों, फिर इसी के साथ मैं विषय प्रवेश करने के साथ इस गंभीर विषय पर आगे और चर्चा और आगे बढ़े, मैं आप सबको क्रांतिकारी अभिनंदन देता हूँ। सबको अल्लाह सलाम।